Wow.
Reverse pendulum, never easy. The best in the world have had trouble with this serve.
Wow.
Soft block here, just testing out the opponent. Timo playing a very efficient game. It's funny, Gao Ning, I can tell you about in a minute, coach for Clarence Chu and the Singaporean men. Maybe I'll save it for a towel break, but right now Clarence Chu off to a good start with nearly 67% of the points available.
Wow.
Another good quick service point. Similar score line to Lily Zhang in the first versus Miwa Harimoto. And on top of the bounce, the quick turn, some bread and butter here. Left-handed players love to step around that backhand. Timo looked like he almost pulled out a behind-the-back attempt. We've seen him make some before. As Clarence Chu surprises him with the down-the-line shot. Now, I'd expect Clarence to turn the corner a little bit more than Timo. Not because Timo's not fast, but Clarence a little bit younger. By a little bit, I mean 15 years. So it's all relative. If you're 15 years younger than Ni Shalien, you're still a veteran of the game. Soft touch and the push play. Timo with the control, the feeling. It's funny, I think Timo Boll has more blades named after him in his likeness and his name any player. Well, definitely than any player currently playing, but maybe any player I can think of. An uncomfortable ball as Timo spins it back slowly. Wow, five in a row for Timo. Love the follow through on the serve, the way he sort of drops the racket to misguide the receiver.
4-7.
It was a runaway start for Clarence Chu, but as discussed earlier, Timo takes his time sort of sizing up the opponent, figuring out what's gonna make them uncomfortable. And a soft block as he gets behind the table. Second towel break and seven in a row for Timo Boll. Leaves it up just a little bit and then blocks it. This ball looks easy, but with Timo on the other side of the table, nothing is.
8-5.
Service gift, this one gets away. A little head shake there from Timo and a second serve. Top edge of the racket, that's the extra top spin that Timo can generate. Really a master of control, Timo Boll.
5-10.
Once again, pinpointing the uncomfortable spot like a surgeon out here. And it is five game points for Timo Magic Boll in the first. Soft block followed up with a bit of topspin from the backhand. Are here. Clarence Chu to start it off. Good idea, the long serve fast to the backhand. Timo patiently waits, casually disassembles. Good placement here from Clarence Chu right into the elbow on the backhand side. Backhand side of the table, Timo's middle. It is so difficult to read that serve. Timo with 12 of the last 16 points. When I see a wince like that from Timo, Timo's been in and out of some injuries, but he's still incredibly physically fit. Sort of have to be at this level. And at this age, him and Zhuang Zhiyuan both, statues. Behind the table, comfortable, giving himself a little bit more time. Normally it's not advised. One of the things that's made Timo, other than his control and his wisdom at the table to make it uncomfortable, one of the things that's made him so tough for Team China specifically is his timing.
3-0.
I say Team China specifically meaning, yes, Team China is better against Timo than any team in the world, but very few have been able to challenge China the way that Timo has for the last two decades plus. Behind the table once again, keeping that top spin on. This could just be the difference. Timo covering from the middle of the body.
Fall.
But Clarence Chu's won, well, half of the points this game, making Timo look quite uncomfortable, playing it into the elbow. Moving Timo around, keeping him guessing a bit. Almost climbs, but the Singaporean fan club here will appreciate that as Clarence Chu steps into the lead. A bit of momentum swing here. Short side of the table, the seatbelt shot. He comes across the body, Clarence Chu, to finish the point successfully. Low ball. Just barely above net height, if. Oh, this shot was too pretty. Timo hit a ball that I thought was pretty miraculous. From the baseline of the table, scrapes it up, and Clarence Chu with a short stroke. Six of the last eight for Clarence Chu now. Getting his mojo back in action. Man. Continuing second towel break. It's funny, in game number one, Timo didn't look tested. In game number two, he looks handcuffed. Clarence Chu finding some serious answers here.
Eight, five.
But a much needed point, a little bit of coal in the chamber here. Timo had gone a long time without collecting pointage.
Let
five. Dear fans, this is the umpire reminding you that that was a let. And five. Now you are free to scream. 5-9, Timo Boll. If Clarence Chu gets a game on the scoreboard, Timo is a master of comebacks. And he's still not down in games. But a nice backhand.
6-9.
Interesting. Fan club, dear fans, replying to email. Timo Boll won that point. And now Clarence Chu sitting on four game points. But he will not be sitting. He will be springing to his feet here. He's got the serves if he needs a second one. Ooh, behind the back, nearly pulled out to play here as Clarence Chu sets up a good third ball opportunity, but Timo survives to save a game point. Jayo, they say. Add oil, give it your all, go for it. Mandarin, one of three languages officially here in Singapore. Speaking of three game points left. And Timo saves yet another third towel break. That three back in action. Interesting. Thinking to myself, Timo Boll has given us so many thrills. I think another left-handed player who speaks Chinese, Lin Gaoyuan, the Dark Knight, probably the most famous comeback of Timo's modern career. The 2017 Nine. Men's World Cup. That is three game points saved and a timeout for Clarence Chu. Backhand does it. Chiquita, banana flick, and the potassium power out here ties it up at one game apiece. Back for game number three. I'll give you the Gao Ning story during this game.
One love.
But there will be more. There is a guaranteed game number four, assuming both players stay healthy. And Timo with the touch. Maybe on towel break will be a good time. Good start here for Timo. After nearly coming back from 6-10 down.
One, two.
And a well-placed serve, Clarence Chuk. When he's got Timo questioning what shot to take, from that camera angle, it looked like there was no question about what shot to take. Just he was not happy he didn't make it.
Three,
bit of frustration on both sides. Little football there, kick up. Timo Boll. Once again, that reverse pendulum serve where he comes around the outside of the ball. He varies so well. Back edge of the table for Clarence Chu. Towel break, Gao Ning story time. Gao Ning had been the leading player for Singapore for quite some time. And I think inside the top 20 for a decent portion of his career, but inside top 30. Timo Boll overslept his alarm, slept for 13 hours, woke up, missed practice, showed up for the match, and finished Gao Ning in about 20 minutes. I think Gao Ning averaged less than 4 points a game. And Timo, if you had seen him, you would have said, did you just wake up? It was very clear, puffy faced and all.
Five, three.
And that's not a knock on Gao Ning. Gao Ning, again, a legend for Singapore in the men's game. That's just how strong Timo is. 2-point game here, Timo in the lead.
Six.
And
three.
His service has been absolute kryptonite right now. Reverse pendulum, no reason to change it. That said, if there's ever a reason, Timo will find it. And straight back to the baseline, like a pendulum serve, except directly under the ball. Straight to the shoulder, not a flinch from our umpire, Rafał Lazarczyk. Check this out.
Seven, five.
2 points between them, Timo on top still. It's Clarence Chu with much to do to winning game number two.
Eight, five.
Ball hitting the beautiful W cage under the table for the W1000.
5-9.
Timo racing ahead. Remember, this is their first meeting. Not so many people in the world are undefeated against Timo Boll, including Ma Long.
6-9.
Meaning Ma Long is not undefeated against his sometimes doubles partner over the years, Timo Boll.
10-6.
And now 4 game points for Timo Magic Boll to go up 2-1. Thinking about that doubles pairing made me think about Durbin and just in general, China mixing up their pairings for doubles. Chop block does not come down. Yeah, would have been cool if it did, because it would have come back. 92 Olympics, also a bronze in singles in Atlanta, 96, Jorg Roskopf, but it's Timo Boll on the table receiving now. Beautiful recovery from Timo. Clarence making the moves to the wide forehand, chases down a shot. A little bit of fortune for Timo early on, hence the hand raised. And this time the chop block comes down, but Timo rarely bothered by spin, a master of it himself. Takes one to know one, a spin master, so quite familiar with the rotation on the ball. The fact that he can play that serve anywhere on the table, fast, short or long, under or topspin, Makes him very tough to rally with. And a quick step here as Clarence Chu gets on the scoreboard. Following just in case that ball comes down. Oh, perfect placement. Timo Boll covering the down the line shot. Clarence turned and burned. Doesn't take long to come back. Timo just getting the racket up and angling it perfectly.
Five, one.
And at the towel break here, it seems like Timo has found his rhythm. He's got 12 of the last 16 points. In game number one, even though he won it 11-5, the way he did it was so casual. It's not to disrespect the opponent, it's simply to figure out what's working for him. Cautious, patient play after the side spin comes in. Chop block comes down. Timo not bothered. Bit of side spin into the elbow. And then more straight top spin to keep it unpredictable. Beautiful play here off the top of the bounce. Clarence Chu putting it through. Bread and butter from early on. Remember, Clarence Chu getting a 10-6 lead in game number two. Timo's had his share of injuries, but last we saw him play was very strong.
2-7.
Again, coming back to beat Tomokazu Harimoto is not easy. A player who beat number one and number two in the world on the biggest stage at the end of 2022.
8-2.
Little fortune here for Timo as he continues. 6-point lead for the Magic Man. And gives one away.
8-3.
Thank you for having us in your country, he says. Quick counter on the forehand side. Now, in terms of exhibition points, if a player's up 10-1, sometimes you'll see a player volunteer a little bit of a exhibition point, something to entertain the crowd. But as soon as it became 3-8, Clarence, with the home crowd behind him, I think is going to be fighting till the finish. 3 serving 9. And Timo now with 7 match points to move on through to the round of 32. Draws on worldtabletennis.com. Catches the back edge.
10-4.
Still alive, Clarence Chu hanging on by a thread. The winner here will play Anton Schelbedi, who actually trains in Borussia Dusseldorf, where Timo trains. Right now, the favorite, Timo. Right back down the line, Clarence Chu. A long way to go. And if it were Timo on the other side, you might believe. And it is Timo who wins it, 11-5, 3-1. Clarence Chu put up a good fight, took a game off of Timo, and had him against the ropes.